internal style sheet means that inside the head tag, we were taking the style tag like this, HTML, head. Then I'm taking the style tag and I'm taking the type attribute. The value of type attribute is either text file or CSS, right? Clear? So in this style tag, we were taking all the selectors that we want to format. On whichever selector you want to apply your formatting facilities. Like suppose I want the background color of the body to be crimson. Okay. Then you are having H1 tag and you want to format the H1 tag by taking font style Arial, font size 50 pixels, font weight bold, then font style italic, right? So on to whichever tag you want to apply the formatting features, you write the tag name and then you write all the necessary properties. Clear? These properties will be applied to the text that is enclosed in H1. Clear? Offline class clear? Online class clear up till here? Ankita, Aditya? All right. Now, suppose I am closing the style tag over here. And I'm closing the head tag over here. Suppose I give you one question. I have given you one text and I ask you people to frame the CSS part and to frame the CSS part in such a way that all the given properties should be applied to that. But I have not asked you to write the entire coding. Your answer will be this, the portion I have shaded. If only CSS portion has been asked, the examiner is not asking you the entire coding and examiner has given clearly to use internal style sheet, your coding will be this much part. Only the portion that contains the CSS, not the complete portion. Clear? If examiner asks you complete coding, then you will continue the coding after closing the head tag. Secondly, if internal style sheet has been asked, you are bound to write coding only using internal style. That time you can't use external or inline style. Third, if no concept has been given whether to use inline, internal or external, then you are free to show CSS part in any of the form. Clear? Am I clear? So continuing this, I start the normal coding with the body tag. Okay. I write H1 over here. I write simple lines. Welcome to school. First day of offline classes. I close the H1. I close the body tag. I close the HTML tag. Right? Let us save this page. Save in documents. I am saving the page with 10th A of .html. Let us see the browser view.
10th A of year. This is your web page.
See, this is the output. Online class, is the browser view visible? Nana? Clear? Offline class? This was, yes. That we will take when we will create separate CSS file in external style sheet. Right now, we are only on the same web page. I have not made any separate coding. On the same page, I have created the CSS internally to the same page. On top, I have CSS part. At the bottom, I have normal coding. All the formatting I have done in the CSS portion and the normal coding I have written in the bottom part. I hope this much part is clear to you about internal style. Now, in this page only, I'll explain you the role of external style sheet. By name, it is very much clear what is external. Here you will have two files. Beta pehle samajh lijiye please. You will have to make two files, two separate files. One file you will make of HTML coding. Okay. One file you will make of CSS part. Then you will create, associate both the files together. You make one HTML file where you will write only HTML coding. No formatting you will do. In the second page, in the second file, you will create this coding of CSS. First file you saved by giving extension .html. The second file of CSS you will create by specifying extension .css. Now your point is clear, Chiang. But you have to link these two files. How to link these two files? These two files will be linked by giving the link tag. Before this CSS, you have learned how to use link attribute. One thing is link attribute in the body tag. Here you will use link tag. That link tag will help to connect, relate, or associate your HTML file with the CSS file. That link tag we will be using inside the head tag. The way I have used style tag inside the head, similar manner, I will be using the link tag inside the head tag. Got my point? Shall we start? Online class, the main meaning is clear of external style sheet. Shall I start the coding? Online class, Ankita. All right. So in this web page only, let me make a duplicate copy of this and I give it the name external code.html. I remove entire formatting from here. Okay. First, I'll be making the simple HTML file. Then I will tell you how to create the link tag. H1, welcome to school for offline class. Okay. Here I am taking UL type equal to disk. Li. Now let us take all the subject names. English. Maths. Science, social computer, and here I close the UL. Okay, then I am taking H3. In H3, I am giving the text. Let us be positive towards upcoming boards. Okay, and I close H3. Right? Now, how to create the link tag so that I can relate my file with the CSS file? Link tag, REL. REL stands for relation. REL attribute means relation. Relation of that external file with our file is a style sheet. We have created style sheet equal to style sheet type attribute equal to text or CSS, right? HREF. HREF. The way you take HREF in the anchor tag, right? What was the role of HREF in anchor tag? To connect with the external page. जैसे मान लीजिए tree.html नाम का पेज है और आपको जंप करके उस पेज पे जाना है. HREF attribute will connect you with that page. Here also HREF will take the name of the target file as value. Suppose you want to save the CSS part with sample.css. इस नाम से मेरी CSS फाइल सेव हो गई. एनी नेम यू कैन गिव, एनी नेम, बट एक्सटेंशन शुड बी डॉट CSS. क्लियर? दिस कमांड इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. इट विल प्ले वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल इन रनिंग एक्सटर्नल स्टाइल शीट. राइट? क्लियर? एम आई क्लियर? नाउ I save this file once again. Now I open the new page. Here you have to take no tag. Not a single tag you have to take. No HTML, no head, no title, nothing. Here you will only take all the tags which you want to format. Which you want to format. Okay. First tag, body. Without angle brackets. Without angle brackets. Background color, I am taking silver. Right? Clear? See, I have not taken any head tag, any title tag, nothing. सिर्फ जिस tag की formatting करनी है वो tag के नाम लिखने हैं बिना angle bracket के. And this body is known as selector here. I told you to call tag as selector in CSS. This is CSS file we are making. H1. H1 we have taken. What all formatting you want for H1? I want Arial font. Color, I want green. Font size, I want 40 pixels. Okay. Then I want to align in the center. Okay. This was my required formatting for H1, right? Now we have taken UL tag also. So for UL tag, what formatting you want? I want color red. I want font style italic. I want font size 30 pixels. Right? For H3, I want font family. What, Dana? I want color blue. I want font weight bold. I want alignment as center. Okay. My desired work is over. Online class, am I clear? Online students, am I clear up till here? All right. Now, click on file, click on save, go in documents, save this file with the name sample.css. Why sample.css? Because in HREF attribute, I have already specified the name, right? Right? Now let us see the browser view. And we are to run our file. External file, where our file has gone. I think we have not saved that file. Okay, I again create the file. Just a minute. Date modified. Yeah, external code, HTML. See? Online class, browser view is visible. Now, suppose you want to change the color of heading. You want to give yellow color. Now, whatever changes you want to make, you will only make change in the CSS file. You will not touch HTML file. Agar koi formatting change karna hai, agar koi style rule change karna hai. अगर कोडिंग में चेंज करना है कुछ लाइंस ऐड करनी है देन यू विल गो इन द एचटीएमएल फाइल बट इफ यू वांट टू मेक चेंजेस रिगार्डिंग द स्टाइल रूल्स यू विल बी कमिंग टू दिस सीएसएस फाइल राइट सपोज हेडिंग इज ग्रीन आई एम गिविंग द हेडिंग येलो ओके सेव इट गो टू ब्राउजर हैव यू नोटिस्ड ऑफलाइन क्लास ऑनलाइन क्लास Have you noticed the change? Any doubt, any queries? Clear? Okay, I have a question from the offline class. Name three attributes of link tag. If you were very much alert in the lecture, you might be knowing name of three attributes of link tag. Yes, Prabhun. Very right, very good. HREF, REF, that is relation and type. Okay, clear? What will be the value of REL attribute? What will be the value of REL attribute? Yes, Tarundeep. Style sheet. Very right, very good. Style sheet. Okay. All right. Now, let us go with the case study. Suppose this is a case study. Which property will be used in order to represent the text in bold form? Font weight. Very good. Which property will be used in order to represent the text in italic? Font style. Which property we will be using for alignment of text in the center? Text align. Bete, whenever you get any question regarding property, whether fill in the blank, whether one word, suppose dash is the property used to align text in the center. Listen, student, write text align. This is incomplete answer. Property has been asked. Property means name of the property and value along with semicolon. This should be your complete fill in the blank. Okay. Am I clear, Aryansh, Chayan, Arpit, Ravneet, clear a bit? Divita, Garima, Diksha, Himanshu, aapko clear a bachche? Sahar, Saksham, Tarundeep. Online students, concept is clear? The last concept is universal selector. Suppose you want to apply one property to all the elements of HTML. In your web page, you want entire text to be red. In every part, you will write color red, color red, color red. We should have such a scenario that only one time we should write red, color red, and that get applied to all the elements automatically. I remove color attribute, a color property from here. I remove color from here. I remove color blue from here. Okay, bete? How to create universal selector? Universal selector means which is universally available for everyone. Denoted by asterisk, star. Color, colon, red. Close it. This universal selector will be applied to the entire web page. Ab dekho, sabhi pe red color aa gaya. Whatever you will write in the universal selector denoted by asterisk, jise aap star kehte ho, that formatting will be applied commonly to the entire page. Okay, bete? Online class, am I clear with the role of universal selector?